Good morning, everybody. I'm Tim Labécha from CEA France. So I will start my presentation to show you a little bit what is CEA INES and where we are, what we are doing, and then I will speak about new solutions for building insulation and how we can put some sustainability in a really waste subject like insulation. So we are next to the French Alps, a bit between Geneva and Grenoble on the east side of France. We are part of the CA, which is 20,000 people, historically working on nuclear-related questions, but INES, where I am, is the National Solar Institute of France. So we are really focused on solar energy. So I give a short overview. This is our plant next to Chambéry. And here we cover the total value chain of solar panel manufacturing from crystallization. Part is missing. So from crystallization, go through by cutting and manufacturing cells and panels, up to integration into buildings. And also energy and electricity related question of solar energy integration. So at INES you can find all part of this value chain. So that's why it's called the National Solar Energy Institution. My division handled this huge experimental platform where we have some experimental buildings and solar test benches, solar concentrated testing also to see the impact of outside condition on real-time performance. But why we are here? Because we work on buildings and we try to link industry with research. So it's a research center and we are dedicated to do technological research and try to bridge the gap between the ID up to TRL3 and the put on market which is around TRL 8-9. So we try to propose some tools to handle this technological transfer from ID until the market. So why we are work on buildings in CA, it's not so evident to see, because these are French data. So in France, 44% of consumed energy is linked to the building sector. And among these 44%, 65% of final energy is dedicated to heating. So it's even higher than the average values of Europe. And what about the buildings in France? The most representative buildings are built, as you can see, in the 70s and 80s. And actually, they are really, really energy consumer. So we need not only focus on new buildings, but also on existing buildings. So that's why we try to work simultaneously on solutions for new and retrofit buildings. So here, of course, we will speak on building in general, but I need to highlight that working not only windows, but also on walls are still some open questions. So we cannot put everywhere glass fiber heat insulation with plaster boards as usually done in France, but we need to find some new solutions to to get a more sustainable solution to reach the new environmental target I use. So here I would like to show you two European projects that we had recently, and both of them worked on aerogel based insulation solutions. So maybe you don't know, so just a short recall on what is aerogel. So aerogel are manufactured by supercritical drying from gels, and in building application we use mostly silicon-based aerogels. So as you can see, these are miraculous products because they are really high-performing materials. They are light, and they have really almost the lowest thermal conductivity on the market. And one point that is less known, that they are mineral products. So it means that we don't introduce organic materials in the building. So when you care about life cycle and environmental impact of buildings, it's quite important to see that aerogels are mineral-based product. So I put some general information on it because maybe you are not so familiarized with it. So the lambda value, the thermal conductivity, is really, really low. And as you see, the density is below 100 kilogram for 1 cubic meter. So one of the highest or the strongest selling asset is this is lightweight and really high thermal performance product. Some new or other aspects is it is hydrophobic and breathable, and it has a really good fire resistance. Of course, I think I will have some question about the price too. So this is an issue, but we already worked on that question, so I will explain it a bit later. But first, I would like to say that we studied two possibilities to use aerogels. The first one was this super insulation panels possibility. Please do not open. So this was the first project when we put silica aerogel, we embedded it in fiber blankets. So this was the Homeskin project where we developed with the aerogel manufacturer some new insulating panels that you can touch shortly, and we integrated it into a complete insulating solution that we put on walls. And the strong point of this project was that we realized a demonstration on the real buildings. So we had four installations, two on our experimental platform, one in Barcelona, not far from here, and one in southern part of France, next to Nizza. So some data on the technical performance. So I let you read it. One point that is not really known, and it was an issue in Switzerland, is the indoor air quality questions about aerogel-based products. Actually, in Switzerland, they had some bad experience on application of these products, and they don't trust it because they fear from nanoparticle emissions of the product. So we involved these questions also both in our project to study if there is really an indoor environmental and indoor air quality issue or not related to this product. So I can tell that there's no VOC or nanoparticle emission from this product. We measured it because actually we need to show to public that there's no issue related to this. So in Hongqin project, we tested two solutions. One was dedicated to one was dedicated to indoor solution. It means that you need to retrofit, for example, a building, and you cannot add anything on the outside facade. So you need to find some solution which are not really thick because you don't have any space. So you need to reach high thermal performance by adding new layers and, if possible, the most performing that possible. So for that, we worked with Trosselen, who was an Italian partner, and developed a sandwich panel, which was also equipped with a layer, which called the third one, which was there to avoid also condensation problems. So sometimes when you add new solution on inside surface, you add some new problems to the existing installation. So if you insulate on the inside, sometimes you create new thermal bridges and cool surfaces, which result in condensation. So we studied those questions also, and we had another system which is dedicated to outside surfaces, which contains this blanket, aerogel blanket, and some rendering on it to avoid damage due to weather conditions. The second project was the Wallace project, which is still ongoing, managed by QuickMix, which is a German partner specialized on mineral-based rendering solutions. So it was the same logic when we submit this project, that a lot of heat is lost through windows, but still we have also the problem with walls. And for that we proposed to develop several solutions during the project, all of them based on aerogel, to try to see if we reach really high performance on the real buildings, and also if we can reduce the manufacturing cost, because as you are aware of it, aerogels are really expensive. So one of the bottleneck problem of this solution was how reduce manufacturing cost of aerogel, and how we can introduce them into rendering products like coatings, not to damage them because they are fragile. For that, I have some other sample. So they are fragile, so you need to introduce them into typical rendering products, but still you know that they are expensive. So what to do? In this Wallace project, we proposed five different new products. So one for outside rendering, one for inside insulation cases. One, it's called like thermal coating, like 1 centimeter thickness, only for those cases when you don't have any possibility to add new layers because it's a historical building, because you don't have any space and just need to increase thermal comfort, for example. For that, we propose this one. And also a fifth product, which called patching filler, with the partner Tupre. It means that you use patching filters in general for small surfaces, but if you add some low-performing product in those spaces, you create new thermal bridges. So the idea was to have something really performant from thermal point of view to avoid introducing new thermal bridge on existing structures. So here I had a slide for each partner's product, just to show how you can put it in place. All the pictures were taken in our experimental platform. So this is in fact. You can see that the devices that they use is the same as you can have in a construction site. So there's no need for special equipment for that. So it. At the end, it looks like normal building materials. So it mixed with water and some other additional product. And you don't need special equipments to apply them on a surface. It's the same. You have a first layer to prepare on the existing wall, and then you just spray it with a with the pressurized machine, and then you just finish the layer. So the patching filler is maybe the most exotic product because you can be interested why we add the aerogel in those products, because it's not really a huge surface. But actually, for example, you can use them for joining plasterboards in indoor environment. Plasterboards are really widely used in France. This is a typical solution in France to insulate from the inside. You put glass wool on the inside surface and you cover it with the plasterboard from typical French industry. This is the most popular insulating solution in France. So for that, this is a really huge market for them to propose something insulating to fill the joint between plasterboards. Also, I forgot them, the fifth product of the project was the filled bricks. We had a partner from Germany who tried to develop aerogel mortar filled bricks. They called Leifinger Bader, and we installed this solution also on the Inca's experimental platform to see in a real size application how it works. So the last one was the external render, and here you can see also they used the pressurized spraying equipment to install it on the wall. So it's completely classical as an installation procedure. Today, we can say that this is the most performing product of the project, because we are not far from the, as you can see, 27 milliwatt per meter Kelvin, which is really, really low for a rendering product. So if you compare it with some other existing render which contains perlite or some not mineral additive, we are really below those values. So here I will show you some nice picture from the from our experimental platform. So in this house, which called Inca's house, we used the coating finish. This is the 1 centimeter thick aerogel-based coating to study the comfort and the indoor air quality issues of the product. On the FACT tool, you can replace walls like this. We study the wall structures. So we built this both wall in it on the north side to study if the product perform as well in real condition as in laboratory conditions. Because as you know, when you buy a new product, you have these nice values on the technical sheet, but usually in a real scale, in a real application, there's a really huge difference between this theoretical and real values. And the last experimental installation is in PASI cells, also in our experimental platform, when we put all the developed product together to see if, as a toolbox, it can work. For the indoor air quality study, this one, you can see we use a reference room when we have only plasterboard installed, and a test room when we added in the same on the same surface the tested product. And as I told you, we studied also nanoparticle and VOC emission, and we can see that no real impact on the indoor air quality was detected. And nanoparticle levels are included within an indoor air quality background range. Actually, we cannot detect if there is more or less nanoparticle in the air, because it stays below the threshold level. So the installation, how it goes. So first, we constructed a brick wall, completely general brick wall. And then the partner came to our platform and installed several layers of the new solution. From the outside, the finished surface looks like an ordinary building. So it's the same render at the end as a normal building. So you cannot detect there is aerogel in it. So we have a brick layer and a 10 centimeter thick aerogel-based render on the outside. And we added some relative humidity, temperature, and heat flux sensor in it to obtain some performance data. So I won't put a lot of curve, just to show you that it takes several months to dry out the structure. This one is in the outside render. So this curve is this one, which is at the middle of the render. So you can see that it was installed on July, and it started to dry at the middle of October. So it's something general, like other products. For the inside installation by Vimark, the Italian partner, it's the same. They used this pressurized machine to spray the layers on the wall. Maybe just one advice, actually it's quite dirty. When you open the bags and just put the aerogel powder in the machine, it makes a lot of dirt. So actually, it's still more interesting to keep it outside of the building for the installation than bring it inside. Of course, maybe it's possible, but it's an advice that we can do, we can give now. So it's the same logic as previously. We put sensors in the wall at several heights to monitor thermal and moisture performance of the wall. So as you can see, the drying process is something similar. At the middle of October, we can see that it started to dry out, and then it continues almost linearly. On this one, we can say that drying process lasts at least 3 months, and the first results of U values show that we reach really low U values, around 0.3. It's less than you mentioned previously, but with not any insulating protected layer added on only by aerogel-based mineral plasters, it's a quite a good result. And at the end, I would like to show you this PASIS test cell where we integrated all the solution of the project together. So it looks like this, and this is the experimental wall that we can take off and adding some tested structure in it. So the first was the installation of Leifinger Badder field bricks, and then from the outside we added the thermal render inside the thermal plaster. And to complete, we added this patching filler a little bit on an artificial way to study them with different formulation and different level of aerogel added in it. And one of the strongest points of this project is that we have real demonstration sites. So maybe you are aware of this gap between planned and real values. So we try to show that how we can reach this theoretical really high thermal performance by adding them on the surfaces. So that's why we propose always this kind of measurements in project to help companies bring their project from a laboratory scale to real scale. And as you can see, for example, in our place, we add these walls here and leave them 1 year, 2 years to work and see what will happen with them and how they perform. So thank you for your attention, and do not hesitate to pick up some flyers outside that I left on our group. Thank you.